Here we are in DaVinci Resolve. I have two videos on the timeline, and in order to create the transition, we need to open Effects panel, then open Effects, and add an adjustment clip to the timeline, one track above the videos. Then we need to adjust the length of the adjustment clip, and for this I'm going to move the time indicator to the point of the cut between the videos, and move 15 frames to the left. Then bring the start of the adjustment clip to this point. Then go back to the point of the cut and move 15 frames to the right. And bring the end of the adjustment clip over here. Now we have the adjustment clip ready to go, and make sure you select it and place the time indicator above it, and then open Fusion page. Then while inside of the Fusion page, select the Media In node and press Ctrl Space, then search for Transform with the XF selected and click Add. Then make sure you have the Transform node selected, and also you have the Inspector panel enabled from here. Now we're going to create a keyframe at the start of the adjustment clip, so move the time indicator all the way to the start, to the first frame of the first video, and create a keyframe for size by clicking on this diamond icon at default value. Then go to the last frame of the first video, just look for it, here it is. Create another keyframe at default value, go one frame forward to the first frame of the second video, create another keyframe, and then go all the way to the end and create another keyframe. So now we're going to leave the first and the last keyframe values at default and adjust the second and the third keyframe. And you can see these tiny white lines are the keyframes, so move the time indicator to the second keyframe. And here it depends what zoom transition you're going for, either zoom in or zoom out. In my example, I'm going for zoom in, so I'm going to increase the size on the second keyframe to 2.5. So we're nicely zoomed in the video, then move one frame forward, and here we're going to set the size to 0.25, so we're actually zoomed all the way out now. Now we have all this blank space that we need to fill, so if we go into the edges settings and select mirror, that automatically fills it up, then go into settings, check motion blur, increase quality to maximum and shutter angle to maximum. So now we have motion blur. And the only thing that's left is to adjust the velocity of the transitions. For this we're going to open spline, then check transform. Then make sure you click on the zoom to fit icon to see all of the keyframes. Left click somewhere in the empty space, then Control A to select all keyframes. Press F on the keyboard, and now you have these handles that we can adjust. And we're going to drag the second handle down like this. And then the third handle, we're going to drag it up. And then we have the first handle, hold the Alt key on the keyboard, click and drag it to the right, not all the way, leave some space between this and this keyframe, and do the same with the last, but hold the Alt and drag it to the left almost all the way. So this is how the graph should look. Now if we go ahead and do the preview, we should have a very nice and smooth zoom transition. Now if we go back to the edit page, it will be over here, perfectly fine and working. So thank you guys for watching.